If you thought choosing between these was hard, well, it's about to get a whole lot worse. Now, even more streaming services are launching, with well over 300 vying for a spot on your screen. But what will all this choice cost us? Currently, US consumers spend one-third of their weekly free time watching movie and TV content. But if you thought cable was dead, you might be surprised. Time watching traditional TV is still much higher than it is for streaming services. We have reached an inflection point, though. For the first time in 2018, a higher percentage of households subscribed to at least one streaming service than to traditional pay TV. Currently, US consumers subscribe to about 3 streaming services, and that number is expected to go up. Cable prices per month averaged $107 in 2018, while streaming prices averaged about $26. Even if you paid for 5 services, it would likely be much less than cable. But just because there's more options doesn't mean people are going to pay for them. There's the free trial exploiters who binge on content and unsubscribe at the end of the trial period. According to one study, that's half of online video subscribers. There's also the moochers, the ones who sign in using someone else's account. And there's the growing trend of free ad-supported streaming, which doesn't cost anything. As the marketplace for video content gets busier and more complicated, one thing is for certain. It's no longer the land of just Netflix and chill.
Hey, thanks for watching. If you like this video, check out these other videos from USA Today to stay up to date with all the latest news.